We have Tracy next with a question. Tracy?
Thank you so much. What a fascinating life you've led, and so many you've introduced so many different ideas about education and chess and all the rest of it. I wanted to sort of pull those together and ask you maybe a three-part question, but it's in one example. In Ecuador, the municipality began to distribute little plastic chess sets and was encouraging the community centers and kids to do chess, more or less to develop critical thinking skills. And then when they changed mayors and things moved on, then an NGO tried to pick this up, and their justification was to say this is kind of like in the old days when we taught logic or Latin, or maybe what the rich schools do in teaching coding, but we want to get this thinking trained early. So I guess the three parts of the question are to see what they are doing compared to what your parents did, aside from this constant practice at a very early age. What else did your family do? That's one part. The second is, what do you think of those kinds of initiatives, and would you back them? And more or less, I guess you've answered, earlier, the better would be good. But the third part of the question goes to this area of the differences between the sexes. When they had these little plastic chess sets and they only had a few, they allowed the kids to take them home. And the kids who took them home were the boys. The girls didn't take home the chess sets to practice, or they were told, take them home and teach your parents, or take them home and use them. And the girls didn't, which was really interesting. And just wanted to pull all those different threads together about, is something like that an early initiative to help just general thinking skills? As you were saying, there's lots of things you can do in those early years programs you saw in Colombia where they help kids just think, if then, anticipate, things. How beneficial that would be in the form of chess, and what you could do, what we could do to actually encourage more kids, girls and boys, to actually participate. Thank you.
Thank you, Tracy.
Well, it's a complex questions and a few questions, so I will try to answer it. First of all, it's great that they had this initiative in Ecuador to give out chess sets. But I think we have to clear some of the basic things, and I always tell this and clarify it for people to understand it, because chess has a 1500 years old history. Their chess was in different parts of different times used for different things. So in education, there are quite a few different ways of using it, especially the way you are asking for everyday knowledge, for skill building, for something that they can use outside of the chessboard. So there are two basic differences when you have the chess coaches, not even necessarily grandmaster, master, they can be lower, but they are chess masters, chess coaches who go into schools or preschools even, and they are picking out the chess set with some stories, but they're actually focusing on the chess activity on the chessboard, right? And they color the story. So it's 80% chess and 20% storytelling, coloring, the games, bringing in maybe some numbers, some math and logic and so on. And the other way of doing it is to give chess as a tool for teachers who are actually going to be using chess for developing their everyday skills they need, 80% or 90%. And it's only 10 or 20% going to be happening on the chessboard and chess moves. And I think this is very important to understand. So the activity what happened in Ecuador, giving out chess set, is an old-fashioned kind of thinking, and from that you cannot expect a great change in mindset or whatever. It's for the kids who like to play games, who are interested. They're going to grab it, take it home, play with the parents or whatever. So just give out something, some tool, without telling them exactly what to do with it. It can be also not dangerous, but it goes on itself, and then you'll see what's going to be the end of it. And it's a great game, so don't misunderstand me. It's something great that kids were getting chess set. I have, for example, a program running in Hungary from 2013. It's part of the educational system, and it's an optional subject. So the elementary school, where the principal decides they want to have the Chess Palace program, which is our program of my foundation, then they can choose it and have it in a classroom. And we do use, we give classes and courses to teachers to understand how and what is the best way we believe the to use chess in the classroom using the numbers, the algorithm, different things, the chessboard, the coordinates, how to use the chess pieces with numbers, because in chess we have the values of each piece, like pawn verse one, knight and bishop verse three, a rook is five, queen is nine, and then we have the king, which we use in our math examples as a jolly joker, so it can be replaced with any number which we don't have in the chess. Or we are making all kind of different games on the chessboard, throwing out letters and then pick a piece and then take the piece, the alphabet letters, and then form a word out of it. Or we have many different patterns which they can use and make them learn daily skills which they are needing in everyday life. Diagonals, right and left, and above you, under you, all these things very interestingly and gamefully we can teach the kids. But this is one way of doing it, and we are not the only ones with this kind of attitude. There are in Spain, there are a lot of different initiatives in South America, in Argentina, in Colombia, I said, I think Paraguay, and some of the other countries. And then there are other countries who use chess as chess. So they have the chess board, they have the chess pieces, they have the booklets of chess diagrams with the chess pieces on it. And those going and focusing much more on the logical thinking, on the combinational skills, on the decision-making skills, taking responsibility and those things. But it is very important to understand that there are many different ways. So when we say chess in school, don't think only that we have a chess board in the school. No, the chess with including many different integration into different subjects. So it's very important to know this. And now we are actually progressing pretty well internationally. I'm an advisor in the World Federation on the Education Matters, also in the European Parliament. I just gave a lecture on benefits of chess. So we are progressing, and it's very important, I think, right now. That's what I'm trying to give the message everywhere, that I think we really need different platforms where we can talk about the values, the benefits for the different age groups of kids, and giving ideas for teachers and institutes. What are the menu? What are the different ways of using chess for different age groups?
Thank you.
Thank you so much. How complete. What an eye opener. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.